From the graph, determine the open intervals for which the function is increasing or decreasing and concave up or down. Also indicate any relative extrema or points of inflection. Let's begin by determining the intervals for which the function is increasing or decreasing. The function is increasing if as x increases, y increases, and the function is decreasing if as x increases, y decreases. If we read the graph from left to right, if we're going uphill, the graph is increasing. If we're going downhill, the graph is decreasing. Looking at the graph from left to right, notice how the function is increasing over this interval until it reaches this high point at x equals negative 2. Also notice, if you were to sketch a tangent line at any point over this interval, the slope of the tangent line would be positive. But then notice from x equals negative 2 here to x equals positive 2, the function is going downhill or decreasing until it reaches positive 2 here, and then it switches back to increasing from 2 to infinity. So notice how it changes from increasing to decreasing at x equals negative 2, and it changes from decreasing to increasing at x equals positive 2. And therefore, the function is increasing over the open interval from negative infinity to negative 2, but then it increases also on the open interval from 2 to infinity, and it's decreasing over the open interval from negative 2 to positive 2. And notice where the function changes from increasing to decreasing, we have a high point, and therefore a relative maximum here. And where the function changes from decreasing to increasing, we have a low point, or relative minimum. So the relative maximum values are the y values, and the locations are the x values. So we can say we have a relative maximum of approximately, let's say, 8.3 at x equals negative 2. Sometimes you'll see the relative maximum mins given as ordered pairs as well. And then we have a relative minimum of, let's say, x equals negative 2.3 at x equals positive 2. And now let's talk about the concavity. Looking at the left side of the graph, notice how this piece is concave down, and it seemed to change concavity right at the y-axis. And then on the right, the function is concave up. So when I get on the left, the function is concave down, and on the right, the function is concave up. And again, we're going to say it changes concavity right at x equals 0, or this point here. So we can say the function is concave up over the open interval from 0 to infinity, and the function is concave down over the open interval from negative infinity to 0. And then finally, the point of inflection, or the point where it changes concavity, looks like it would be the point 0, comma 3, the point right here on the y-axis. I hope you found this explanation helpful.